I figured that'd be a positive that I make a video this time of something that isn't me ranting about something for 15 minutes and rambling, and then that rambling leading to another 15-minute ramble. Why? Well, I understand how the mind works, and I understand that while it might be interesting the first 3 times, after a while it gets kind of old. So, here's another Q&A. This time it's not about a lot of wrestling stuff, which, I mean, there's been a lot of stuff that's happening, but I'm sure some people have said it much better than I. Now, question number 1, and this is all coming from a user named Son of Tanit. Not good at pronouncing shit. Not that it matters, I mean, he'd understand it. What do you physically do to become a better worse person? What do I do to become a physically better or worse person? I mean, I'm still working out. Albeit, my diet has went from being really good in the later period of 2011 to sucking complete ass. So, I'm not necessarily building the protein I need. I'm just cutting my muscles up. Granted, I don't lift really heavy weights. I lift lighter weights, so the cutting process is more time-consuming, yet it's still better than nothing. And, you know, when you live with parents that support fad diets and don't really want that meat shit, don't really want that vegetable shit, you're obviously not gonna have enough good food in the house to sustain your lifestyle. But I'm getting there. My goal is to look less like I'm straight out of a third world country, because that's just not gonna suffice. I'm so much better than that. I can't look like someone can take a picture of me, put it on Facebook and say, one like equals one prayer. Help this man. Call his number right now and give him some food. I can't look like that. I can't look like I'm dying all the fucking time. It's frail ass nigga. Let me see. Next question. I mean, it's all a physical thing. Had you ever read or study anything in particular to become mentally stronger? Well, actually, I like to study. I was always big into music ever since I hit puberty. So I like guitar. Whenever I feel I need to be a better person, I go back to guitar. I might like lose sight of the goal for a few weeks, and then something will show up, like socially, since when you're like me, you have a lot of musical connections, a lot of people you've jammed with. So when they do something interesting, all of a sudden it reignites your passion. So that's sort of like my mental toughness thing, philosophy and guitar, a lot of things like that. Especially with politics, because when your perspective of the world changes for you, you become less naive. That's mental toughness. When you can feel more like a boss when you speak, because you know that what's bullshit and what's not bullshit, that's going to give you an edge. That's going to take you out of that matrix, and that's going to make you more tough, because right and wrong for you has changed a little. And when right and wrong has changed a little, you're harder to manipulate. So, a lot of things that go there, but mostly it's guitar. Not that I'm some sort of virtuoso, but there you go. Okay, next question. I drew a little. I can't help it sometimes. Have you ever been bullied in school? Well, actually, in freshman year, a lot of people bitched me out a lot of time. if you can call it that. I mean, mostly it's these couple of motherfuckers that were pissed because their girlfriends were hitting on me. And these girls were the most hysterical motherfuckers I ever met. No, seriously, they were fucking assholes. And later on, it came back to bite them in the ass. These are the kind of people that like abusive relationships, very egotistical. If you don't fit that beta orbiter thing, or you basically aren't the alpha male, they're not gonna like you, because you're either supposed to shower them with compliments, or you're gonna essentially game them out. And these guys wanted to kick my ass because those girls were getting a little too friendly with me, a little too much of that, hey, let's hit on David for a minute mode. That's not a good mode of thought, really. Because you know that, because these girls know that their guys are going to want to kick my ass. And they don't care. They don't fucking give a damn what happens to me. They just want to, like, piss me off, get an emotional reaction. Get an instinct that'll, like, say, hey, I just hit on David Fabry and it made him a little uncomfortable. That's so awesome. And that's what fucking happens. And that's where a lot of fucking drama happened to me. Like, I even remember it was one time where this guy said that, hey, you try to kiss my girlfriend, I'm gonna whoop your ass. And I was just joking, but they're like, no, I'm about to get my ass beat. And that was, like, the first class, and then at the last class, her cousin, who was also, even though she's like a, supposed to be leaving high school, still a freshman, just like the girl, she's like, oh, that guy's gonna kick your ass. And then her boyfriend came, the cousin's boyfriend came, and then he said, hey, why are you talking to my girl now? I said, whatever. And everyone started laughing, because it's like, it's not that big of a fucking deal, chill. And of course, niggas start smelling bitch because I was really helpful to my motherfucking friend. So you got a lot of guys that are trying to, like, spot the weakness guy, spot the guy that's weak and try to, like, get on his bad side. You know, take advantage of him and shit. So you got a lot of people like that. And of course, when you get older, you get wiser, you basically try and fuck those niggas up, which is what I do. Either verbally, physically, or just press them. Because they ain't shit. The fact is, like, it was mostly, like, black people, and these black people aren't toned as fuck. I'm skinny as fuck, but they're, like, you know, fucking sticks and bones. Shit, so it's, like, no intimidation factor. I can say whatever the fuck I want. I know they're not gonna do any shit about it. Why? Well, because these guys probably don't get bitched out that much, except for maybe their parents or their mom. Well, their mom, because their dad ain't there. And, well, they've probably never been bitched out by a real nigga, so they're not going to do shit. They're going to be too intimidated to do anything. Because these bitches will yell at them for any reason, just because they feel like shit. I do it on principle. You piss me off, I'm gonna start talking some shit to you. Start doing some shit to you, so there you go. And if you were ever presented with a choice of either pushing a red button that would wipe out all humans on Earth, but keep you and the rest of the planet unharmed, or you burning to death and thus saving all humanity, would you push that red button? Now, this is something I've thought about before. And this was back when I was in my martyr phase, which was like 4 years ago. And that's not really relevant since you're 13 and you're a little more naive, a little more hopeful. Ordinarily, I would have chose, all right, I'm going to be the martyr and save humanity by sacrificing myself. I'm pretty sure that in a cost-benefit analysis, that's not going to do any good. Because humanity being brought back to difficult period. It's going to be worth it, the destruction of mankind. At the same time, 3 years ago, even 2 years ago, if you would have presented a choice of wiping out all humanity except for people that aren't fucking pricks, I would probably chose that too, but you know what? The good thing about the universe and how it works is that we're going to see either of those things happen gradually. One of those things we're going to see happen gradually. In fact, I think both are going to happen, in a sense, gradually. Because in order to save humanity right now, you got to destroy it. And honestly, both kind of have the same ending. So, in the end, the needs of few outrun the needs of many. Should I sacrifice myself, or am I just better than that? Am I worth more than all the people that are going to have to die out? You know what? I think I'm worth more than any of those fucking choices. Because I'm the realest. How many people you know that can say that? How many people you know that say, alright, I'm not going to sacrifice myself because these niggas is bitches. I mean, if I were to sacrifice my life, imagine what they would do with that. They would make me another shit thesis related to every other motherfucker I hate. I would be the symbol of that which I already dislike. And if I push a button and kill everyone else, then that just makes me a new thesis. That just makes me the symbol for those harsh Machiavellian hard patriarch dictators instead of the soft guys that know their role and put other people in that position and are fair to a sense. The caring fodder, which is the kind of role that I want to take eventually, where yeah, I can be a little harsh at times, but I care. I'm not gonna make those difficult, hard-ass sacrifices all the fucking time and not give people the benefit of the doubt. So that's kind of my... That's all the questions, basically. What can you learn from me out of this? Well, essentially that... I'm not one of those guys that likes to pretend he's badass. Because everyone nowadays is like, I could be the nicest person, but don't test me because I have a dark side. That's not me. That's not me. I just do what I think is right. And what I think is right is what I do. My sense of morality and my actions may not be the most correct, the most logical, the most helpful, or even likable, but it's just something that I gotta deal with, and I keep modifying it, I keep improving it, yet I know that when I see bullshit, I gotta do something about it. Why? Because otherwise, you deal with that abyss so much, you deal with that sense of atomism too much, and you become atomistic. That's not something I want to deal with, so I want to stay that character that isn't that way. I don't want to get lost in the fucking matrix. Anyway, that's about it.